units and measurements.
Good morning, student. Today we have to study the errors in measurement. But before that, you know the main difference between the mistake and error. Mistake can be avoided. It means that their value may be zero. But error is not avoided. Only their magnitudes are decreases. Right? But now again here, what is mean by the error? Error is nothing but the difference between the observed value and actual value of that observation or reading, whatever. Right? So that difference is nothing but the error. Right? And this error, which is arises due to the faulty observations of a physical quantity. Right? Now here, basically there are two types of the error. First one is the systematic error and second one is the random error. Now, first of here, we want to see the systematic error. This systematic error, which is arises due to the instrument, that is the calibration of an instrument, again, which is arises due to the faulty techniques of the experiment, and again, which is arises due to the observer. Right? So, on the basis of that here, again, this systematic error, which is divided into the three parts. First one is the instrumental error. Second one is the imperfection in experimental technique. And third one is their personal error. Again, in that, we want to see the instrumental error. This instrumental error, which is arises due to the defective calibrations and instrument. What happened here? This instrumental error, which is arises due to the defective calibrations of an instrument. It means that when that instrument is calibrated, and on that instrument, suppose that if you want to calibrate the scale, and that scales are not properly calibrated. For ideal, suppose that if you take the simple scale, that is 1 feet scale, on that what happened? The difference between the, or the distance between the two lines is there 0.1 centimeter. But when that scale is calibrated, at that time, the distance between the two lines, which is not same, so that that distances are different, right? So the errors which is arises due to such problems, then such error called as the instrumental error. See here, suppose there, if you take this circular scale, now here, now this will be the first line, this will be the second one, now this will be the third, fourth, fifth, this one. If the distance between the two lines which is not proper, that is, this distance is different for different divisions, then at that time there the errors which is arises, and the such errors called as the instrumental error. Again, suppose there, if you take the weighing balance machine, in that what happened? Again here, the scale which is calibrated in kg, then again the distance between these two lines which is not uniform, again the error which is arises due to that, then such error which is called as the instrumental error. Sometimes here the position of this one is, that is zero, position of zero is not proper. When If we not connected any load or any mass to this weighting machine or balancing machine, then and then here the position of zero and the position of that pointer which is a not match, right? Again, this error which is arises due to this also, right? Suppose there, if you take ammeter or voltmeter, when we not connected this ammeter or voltmeter in a circuit, then and then the position of pointer is whether on the second or third line. Actually, their position is here, that is on the zero, because of no current or no potential which is applied to this one. Then and then the position of this pointer on the second or third line, right? Again, this error which is arises due to this position also. Right? Again, the such error which is called as the instrumental error. Now, we want to see the second one. That is imperfection in a experimental technique. It means that when we use the technique for to take the readings. Right? In that technique, or that technique is not perfect, then and then there are errors which is arises, then such errors which is called as the systematic error. For example, suppose there if we want to measure the volume of a liquid, suppose if we want to measure the 1 liter of suppose that liquid, actually here if we want to measure the 1 liter of that liquid, for that here we use this, suppose here this will be the one of the instrument, using this instrument we want to measure that, but when we measure that liquid, then at that time if we hold such instrument just inclined, right? Again, there the errors which is arises, right? Then such error which is also called as the systematic error, right? So this is about the imperfection in a experimental technique. And now again here, in that your third one is the personal error. This personal error which is arises due to the person or observer. See here. This error which is arises due to the fault of the observer or person. If the observer is not concentrated on that readings, then at that time there the difference which is produced or errors which is arises. Right? So such error which is also called as the systematic error. Right? Now, this is about the systematic error. Now, we want to see the second type of error, that is the random error. Here, this random error which is arises even after the following the all the procedure to minimize the systematic error. It means that if we avoid all the errors, that is the, all the possible errors, that is the systematic error, then and then in that observation or in that reading there are errors which is produced, then such error which is called as the random error. Again, mainly this random error which is occur due to the variation in conditions in which experiment is performed. It means that suppose there if you want to take the experiment of to measure the temperature. If we perform the experiment at the time of morning, then afternoon, again in evening, then at that time the climatical conditions are there different. Due to that climatical conditions, there the difference in temperature which is arises, then such error which is called as the random error. Again, suppose there if we want to measure the suppose there current in a circuit, but due to the fluctuations in AC signal, the current in a circuit which is the changes. So this error is not due to the person, not due to the instrument. Then and then this error which is arises, so that's why such error called as the random error, or such error which is also called as the accidental error. Because of their climatical conditions or the conditions for the experiment which is suddenly changes, due to that there the errors which is arises, then such error which is called as the random error, or that is also called as the accidental error. Right? See all the errors here.